Welcome or welcome back to the channel. If it is your first time seeing my face, a lovely welcome. I'm Erica and this is Faith Talks. I have to always go back to this because it's who I was and who I am becoming, right? So as I am becoming more of whom it is that God has called me through, it's like, you know, how it's like the old man has passed away and all has become new, right? However, it's important to remember who you were, like not to hold on to it, to say, oh my gosh, I used to be this person and continue with the guilt and the shame. But for instance, there may be situations that you've gone through in life and it so happened that God wants for you to minister to someone. And because of your walk that you have gone through, because of the experiences that you've experienced, God will allow you to use what you've experienced to outreach to somebody, to minister to them, because they can relate. You can relate with what it is. Relate, you know, it's relatable. Your experience is relatable. So in that aspect of it, I'm saying that sometimes it's good to remember where you're coming from, right? So I'm a new creation. Old things have passed away, but we are human. You see it? Yeah, you see what I'm getting at? However, I remember when I was living a lukewarm life, and while I was lukewarm, one thing I do notice, and I will say, is that I noticed that there were times when I would say things and like, okay, for instance, I've had friends where they've shared with me, hey, I'm going so-and-so, and I'm like, you know what, it's not a good idea to go there. I just had this really horrible sense that it wasn't going to be a good outcome. And I've shared with individuals, I think I've touched on this before, right? Also, I've gotten into relationships where God has shown me certain things about individuals and I was like, maybe it's just my mind, I'll go see for myself. I kind of disregarded those red flags because I just thought, you know, it's just my mind playing tricks on me. It's not real. It's going to turn out good, and ended up turning out bad. I learned then that was God showing me that, hey, this thing isn't right. I got you. Do you trust me that I got you? And I was like, no, I didn't trust him. Right. And I'm looking over my life now, as I can honestly say, I'm not perfect, but I know I'm no longer who I used to be. And I will always say that I have things that I struggle with, but I'm not who I used to be, right? You may have known me as a person who used to do this and this and that. I won't do that anymore. I was that, but I'm no longer that, right? So I'm just saying, even though those old ways have passed away, the things that I've done, I'm now at a place where I am, I guess, accepting that, or walking into the gifts, because God has given us gifts, right? So I'm now walking into my gifts and I'm seeing that God has allowed me to know what it's like to say, okay, yeah, you know what? God does have a calling on my life. And I can even see that, okay, I went through that. Obviously, it's for a reason. But I'm hoping I don't ever have to repeat those mistakes again. That, you know, it's like, I don't want to learn any more life lessons. It's like, I want to learn life lessons, but I don't want to go around the same mountain. I want God to show me what it is I need to see so I can avoid said things, right? And so I've now become, you know, where I'm walking in my purpose, where I'm seeing the gifts that God has given me. And it's almost as if it's certain things that happened before where I'm like, God, is this what you want me to do? And he literally showed me things like, no, it's not. And I'm like, okay, let me be obedient and not do that. And I've seen where there are moments where it's like I go against him and I suffer the consequences of it, right? And so now I'm at a place where it's like he's showing me certain things, like I'd see some things and I'm like, God, is that you? And he would confirm it through dreams and he's like, yeah, it's me, don't do that. And I'm like, okay, I won't do it. And I'm just taking it as that I won't do something if God is telling me not to do it. Okay, and that's where my message is coming from. That was just a little backstory, or a little, you know, kind of like a little root, or I guess explanation as to why I'm sharing this message. See, maybe you have gone through similar experiences where you kind of doubted, you know, your ability to hear from God because you thought that it was just your mind playing tricks on you. Which leads me to say this. You may be trying to get into a relationship, but you've gone through relationships before where you now know your non-negotiables. You now know what it is you'll tolerate and what you won't, right? And maybe people have approached you and they seem nicely packaged, right? And you're like, this person might be it. The way they communicate, they seem to be emotionally intelligent. They seem to be whom or what it is that I could want. There may be a future here. Maybe this is God. And you bring it before God, but you didn't wait. A lot of us do that. It's like, okay, I'm presenting this to God and God didn't give you an answer. It may take weeks, it may take months, or maybe God is even showing you a sign that no, this is not the person. But because it's not that you're so determined, but you're still at that place where you're learning to trust God and you're like, maybe it's just my mind playing tricks on me. Maybe it's not God showing me this. You know, your old ways are still there. Not your old ways, but just your old way of thinking. And that's why the word of God talks about that we're to renew our mind so that we'll know what God's perfect will for our lives are, right? And so it's like you still kind of have that old way of thinking that maybe this isn't really God showing me to avoid this person. Maybe it's just me, right? And so you're going head first and you're expressing how you feel about this person. You're expressing what it is you'd want, your dreams and your aspirations. God has answered you already, but you kind of just brushed it off. Like, no, you know, God, this is right. I've waited for a while. This is my answered prayer. And God has shown you, no, this is not it. Okay, it's not. The first, second, God showed you it wasn't it. And then you know what? Hey, if you're there, I'm like that at times. But God is so patient with us. He's so merciful that it's like, in spite of how much you see that he's showing you something, because your heart is so pure and because your relationship with God is just so, it's like he's so gentle with you, you know? And you're like, okay, God, I'm at your feet. And he's like, yes, you are at my feet and I don't want you to go through that thing again. So I'm going to keep on letting you know that this isn't my will for you. And you keep going and you're like, okay, well, if it's not your will, God, can you show me? And he's showing you little things. And he's, you know, I don't know if you're like me, but I'm like, okay, God, can you show me the thing the way that you know that I will get it? And so when you show it to me the way that I'll get it, then I'll get it. Because if you show it to me another way, then I won't get it. But you know me so well, God. Do you follow? You know me so well. God knows us so well that he will warn us in a way that makes sense to us. And it's not going to make sense to anybody else, okay? It could be your, something random where you're on a video call and God is like given a sad face, you know, an emoji pops up and it's a sad face, or it's a thumbs down, or it's a thumbs up. God can use anything, okay? That's what I believe. You know what? I believe it, okay? God can use anything. And so something may happen and he shows you, okay, that's me telling you not to do that. And you're like, are you sure, God? And he gives you a dream. It's like, you remember that thing that I showed you? That was me. Remember that thing? That was me. Stay away, okay? And people may not understand that God is telling you that they are not the one for you. And God is telling you to block and delete them. They may not understand it. And they want you to keep on going back to God. And God is saying, you don't need to come and ask me again. I'm still going to give you the same answer. The answer is no. So if you don't heed the warning of God to block that person, delete and lose all communication and all ties with that person, is going to hurt you. Okay? That person may appear well packaged, well, whatever it may be you desire, because God knows what we want. He may be exactly what you think you're looking for, but God is saying, this is not it. He's not the one. Okay? And God will show you certain things, just like how I was touching on before, how you may have non-negotiables, right? And this person, time and time again, has done things right? That you know as an individual, those are things that, again, they're non-negotiables. Do not, like, it's like, don't do A, B, and C. Kind of like, you don't like somebody smoking. You find out that person smokes and you still ignore it. Like, it's okay. It's just one cigarette a day. No, it's your non-negotiable for a reason. Okay. You may not like how that person call you a certain time of the night. Cut off, Mark, maybe, I don't know, 7 o'clock. That person calls you after 10 o'clock, not once, not twice, but keeps calling you. And you're like, okay, you know, my non-negotiable is do not call me at a certain time. And they ignore that. They don't respect your boundaries. To you, that is a sign, but yet you ignore it. And God is literally, I believe God is able to keep kind of like that nudging us, saying, this is not what I want for you. This is not what I want for you. This is not what I want for you. And you're finally going to get it. It's all going to make sense to you. You're going to be like, you know what, God, this is not what you want for me. So I'm going to let it go. And when you finally let it go, the person is not going to see it the way you see it. Guess what they're going to see? Well, I don't see why you don't think I'm the one. I don't have ill motives for you. But it's not a matter of them not seeing their motives. It's a matter of knowing the God you serve knows the heart, the thoughts, and the intents of individuals and the motives. So because of the God you serve, they may not even know that they have even evil motives for you. Or maybe they do know, but they're under false pretense. They're a counterfeit. So they're appearing to be that which it is that they're not. Because the enemy wants for them to come into your life and cause havoc. And God is saying, my daughter, I know what it is that's best for you. My son, I know what it is that's best for you. Stay away from this person. You may block, you may delete, you may try to lose all communication with them, and they may set up new accounts, may change, get new ways, because, you know, technology these days, you're able to create new accounts, new phone numbers, and they can contact you or whatever. Listen, do not give in. Remain steadfast and immovable, and continue sticking to what it is that God says. Stay away from this person. What is God saying? Stay away from this person. If you continue to ignore the warnings that God has given you and thinking that, you know, it's because the enemy doesn't want us together, you're going to go back to that place that you were before where God has shown you, hey, stay away from this person. You're going to have to learn the hard way. And like I said, it's understandable if you can share certain life lessons with individuals, but you're no longer the same person. Old things have passed away and all has become new. So yes, it is okay in a sense to kind of have a relatable experiences to share with others, but it's not okay to be at that place, because morning by morning, we're seeing new mercies. We're changing. God is changing us. It's this new stages that he's taking us to. And you don't want to go 10 steps back. You don't want to go back to your past, to where you were before, with where God showed you something. You're like, yeah, God, I know it's you, but I'm going to see for myself. No, there's no need to see for yourself. No, God has already seen it. And he's telling you, he's trying to convey, not trying, he's conveying that message to you with signs, with videos, with the social media, just with the things that these individuals say, the things that they do, them not respecting your boundaries, them not understanding non-negotiables, them not understanding that you've made a decision, I don't want you to be in my life, and them trying to change your view of what it is you already know about them. Them thinking that there's a side of them that is better than what they've shown you. No, God is saying, stay away from them. God is saying, block, delete, lose all communication. And it's important that we do that. It's important that we listen to God, because I'm telling you, when the enemy sends people in our lives, at times they themselves may not even know that they're being used by the devil. Okay? And it's important for us, honestly, to heed God's warning, because we don't want to go back again to where it is that we once were. We want to move ahead, okay? And we want to be elevated. We want God to show us new levels. You know what I mean? We want to go there. We want to grow. We want a new mindset. We want to develop and become who it is that God has called to us to be. We don't want to waste any more time. I don't know about you, but I don't want to, you know, like certain things you look at and it's like, man, it would have been nice to be here. And sometimes the reason we're not where we would like to be, it's like you have to wonder, is it because we disobeyed that which it is that God has told us to adhere to? It could be. So we don't want to cause any more delay in our lives. We don't want to cause any more stagnation in our lives. And I'm saying we because I know you and I are on the same page. We don't want to start, we don't want to alter anything that God is trying to do in our lives. So if God is saying keep them away, keep them out of your lives, adhere to that, because we don't want any more cycles around here. I don't know about you, but I'm hoping you're on board with me where you're saying, I don't want any more cycles in my life, and I am heeding the warning, the voice of God, and regardless of how silly may appear to be to others, you think, no, God's not showing you that. No, God couldn't show you that about me because I mean you well. No, God already knows. Again, he knows the intents, the thoughts. He knows everything of an individual. Only God is like, who knows a heart better than the one who creates it? Right? So there's no trying to think, oh, there's some good qualities in an individual. There may be, but they're not good enough. Okay. God has better for you. And another thing I just want to quickly touch on is that I remember, like I said, I've gone into relationships before where I wasn't attracted to the person, but I was looking for things. Okay. You know, we have good conversations, so I can look past my non-negotiable. No, you can't. Don't do it. Okay. There's a reason why you have those desires, because why? That's what you like. You like what you like. You may want somebody that's, this is six foot two, okay? God will sometimes make them a little bit taller than you, or he may, you know, but if it's something where it's like you're looking at them and it's like, okay, what is there that I can like about you? Your attitude, no. And then you get upset at them and it's like, you're so ugly, I'm sorry, okay? I mean, not, but anyways, if there's something you don't like about a person, you don't like it. I'm not saying be picky or whatever, be like, no, I don't like that about you. But it's like, listen, all I'm saying is that when God shows you something about a person, he's showing it to you for a reason, okay? I've made up my mind to say that, you know what, if it means being single for the rest of my life, I'm okay with that. I won't be the first, and I know I will not be the last. I just wanted to share that word with you and let you know that, hey, listen to God, because he knows what's best. All right, thank you so much for watching the video. God willing, you'll stop by for my next one. Until then, take care. Bye. Bye for now.